Welcome back. Holidays are a time of giving, and a lot of us will get tech gifts this year, but it turns out there is a connection between how much we rely on our phones and tablets and neck and back pain. So we're joined with Dr. Jake here, and we're going to talk a little bit about that. So yes, we do get phones and tablets a lot this year, and you know, we will continue to.
Yep, and they're great gifts, and everybody's always going to be using them. The problem is the way people are using now, it's ruining their posture.
Mm-hmm. I know that's, I'm like this a lot, walking across the street like this.
Just like this the whole time.
Yeah. So what can that do like to us?
So what happens is as you move the head forward, it puts strain and tension down through the neck. And that's what this here is. Normally, an average head is 10 to 15 pounds. Mm-hmm. When you're upright, it's sitting here, it's easy to hold. As soon as you start to look down and move forward, it gets heavier. It puts more strain, more tension through the upper back and neck.
Ugh, that does not sound good. Yeah, I will hold this. I do kettlebell swings sometimes, and this is pretty heavy, and that would be pretty...
About what the head weighs normally.
Oh my gosh. So leaning down like this all the time is not good.
It's not.
Okay. What can we do? Because I want to stay on my phone.
Yeah, so there's different ways to help with it. One is tuck the elbows in. Mm-hmm. It can rest on your side. That way you can have it up in front of you like this here. The other, less proper is... tuck the chin in like this. You can still be able to look down, but nobody wants to do that because it gives the double chin.
Yeah, that's
and
right.
Anything, but.
And you're sitting next to Hanan. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, she works behind the scenes here. But you have some issues yourself.
Yes.
What's going on?
I am too young to be a grandma, and I am a grandma inside. So I always wake up with headaches. I have neck pain right now, and I'm trying different sorts of pillows, but it's not really working for me. So
yeah, and that's a thing that we see a lot of times from this, that constant position and posture, it leads to headaches, migraines, other things, even digestive issues, depression, things that you don't normally relate to posture as mm-hmm. well. And it's just putting too much strain through the upper back up
that's
here
where it hurts.
To where it's tension all the time.
So Hanan is on her phone too much.
Possibly,
yes.
So I know with children, they get tablets actually too, so they can play on them, do intellectual games and things like that. Is there anything that they can do? What can parents do to help their children as they get older?
So a reminder, there's actually a campaign. It's called Look Up America. And the goal is you want to take what's called a mobile moment. So as you're playing, you're sitting there for so long, you just want to take a minute, sit up, stretch, look around, and then you always need to limit the kids' time as well on there so they're not constantly hunched over.
That's right. And so with Hanan here, is there something that she could do as far as, I don't know if there are stretches or what can she do right now since she's experienced?
So right now, an easy stretch to do is you'll sit up. Imagine you have a string coming from the top of the head mm-hmm. and you want to roll the shoulders down and back, and you'll just feel the tension release back here. And then just work on that. You'll hold it for about 10 to 15 seconds. Okay. And that's something you can do sitting at your desk, at work, different things, every 30 to 60 minutes or
while
so.
I'm
just
prompting.
Sit up and take it. Yep.
So just readjust and kind of like stop and think about what you're doing and then straighten your back up a little bit.
Just take a minute to stretch and look back up.
Yes. I know another issue, I guess, when it comes to our phones and being on them is the walking part of it.
Yep. The Pokemon craze of people mm-hmm. walking like this, walking into traffic, different things as well. Yeah. It's definitely dangerous.
Yes. So we can learn some lessons from you, Dr. Jake. Thank you. Yep. Hanan, hopefully you get better soon.
Thank you. I'll
be on your case about your phone. So there we go. So thank you guys so much for joining us. We appreciate it. It's now 7:34 and we will be right back.